All right. Thank you so much, everyone, for joining us today. We are delighted to be here with Josh Demby and so many of our Birthright Israel Foundation supporters. So as I think many of you know, June is Pride Month, and we're so excited to speak with Josh and take a deeper look into Birthright Israel's LGBTQ trips. So thank you so much, Josh, for being here today. Just so everyone knows, Josh is a Denver native with a thriving real estate career. He spent 6 years as a marketer in the advertising technology industry. He earned his MBA from the University of Colorado and a BA from Georgetown. Josh participated in Birthright Israel in 2010 and is now a Birthright Israel Foundation Ambassador and a proud member of APAC. So right before we begin, I just would like to share a little bit about Birthright Israel's LGBTQ trips for anyone that's new. First of all, in the last few years, thanks to our incredible supporters, we've had 45 Birthright Israel buses dedicating to experiencing Israel's LGBTQ culture. And we've also made it possible for over 480 participants to attend the Tel Aviv Pride Parade. And if you've been fortunate enough to go, it is absolutely incredible. The energy, I think everyone across the globe can feel it. It's absolutely amazing. And lastly, but not least, which is a really important aspect of all of our LGBTQ trips, is the Madrachim and Israelis are also part of the community, which I think really helps create a unique and life-changing experience for our diaspora participants. And all of our LGBTQ trips are obviously part of our larger offering of niche trips that your generosity makes possible, helping to ensure that there is a Birthright Israel experience for everyone and that no Jew is left behind. So with that being said, we'd love to hear from you, Josh. Everyone watching, we've got just a few questions that kind of dive into the importance of these trips in honor of Pride. So let's get started. Thank you, Josh. So first, I think everyone would really want to know, how do you think Birthright Israel played a role in your life as it relates to being Jewish and a member of the LGBTQ community?
Well, first, let me say thank you so much for having me. It is such an honor to be with you. And I really appreciate you guys having this conversation during Pride Month. I think it's really valuable. Yeah. I think this question is really important because for me, Birthright was very much about exploring these two parts of my identity. You know, I grew up in a liberal Reform Jewish household. We celebrated Passover and the high holidays. I was bar mitzvahed, but I never really had a strong connection to my Jewish identity. In fact, I struggled with how to be both Jewish and gay, despite growing up in a very welcoming home and accepting community. So when I became eligible for Birthright, I wasn't even sure if it was something I would be interested in. But my dad, who has been a lifelong supporter of Israel, really urged me to consider it. And, you know, I was concerned that I would potentially be the only gay person on my Birthright trip, you know, concerned about tokenism, concerned about not being able to experience Israel authentically. Yeah. But in my internet searching, I luckily found that there was going to be an LGBT-specific trip that summer. I later learned it was only the second time they had run the trip. But I was really glad that they had decided to do it this second time because it allowed me to explore these two parts of my identity with like-minded LGBT Jews. It really showed that there was a place for me, for people like me in Israel. In fact, the state of Israel is incredibly progressive and welcoming to the LGBT community. And, you know, that welcoming feeling just made the entire trip and the entire country so much more special, you know, above and beyond sort of spiritual and religious connections that I made as well.
I think a lot of our alumni can definitely relate to those feelings that you had too. I think, you know, it's very special that we're able to provide this gift to anyone. So with that being said, like something I think we always love to hear is what was the biggest highlight of your trip outside of, you know, getting to experience Israel and all of its magic for the first time?
Mm-hmm. You know, frankly, the biggest highlight for me was that we got two Shabbats. And, you know, if you had told me that before the trip started, and of course they did, I don't know that I would have cared. Shabbat was not something that my family or I really observed growing up. And so I didn't really appreciate that two would be great. But it was a really nice opportunity for all of us to connect, to bond, to really be there together. You know, our first Shabbat was on this kibbutz in the northern part of the country. And because we couldn't leave the kibbutz, it was fun to see all the other Israelis there, just relaxing and enjoying spending time with each other. And then our second Shabbat was in this park overlooking the old city in Jerusalem. And it was so beautiful. And it was the tail end of our trip. And so it gave us this incredible opportunity to reflect on the friendships we had made, everything that we had experienced together. It was really magical and just a wonderful way to bookend the trip. So a real highlight for me.
Yeah, I think for most of our participants, the first time that they experience a real Shabbat is on Birthright Israel, and they take it away and they'll have Shabbat dinners in any form that they want for years because they're learning what it is. So we have another question. Why do you think Birthright Israel should continue to have LGBTQ themed trips?
Well, I think affinity trips, LGBTQ other or otherwise, are incredibly important just in terms of creating a really welcoming atmosphere for the people that are on them. You know, I think like me, a lot of people struggle with dual identity or having multiple identities and sometimes feel like they have to pick one. Mm-hmm. And this trip showed me that it didn't have to be that way, that I could be both Jewish and gay, that I could live both and I could celebrate both. And ultimately, I don't think it matters how you identify. Israel can be a homeland for you. And the affinity trips really allowed me to appreciate that with people that shared my same values.
It's incredible to hear. So just so the audience knows, about 25% of all Birthright Israel participants do choose a niche affinity style trip, whether it's LGBTQ, culinary, arts and entertainment, outdoor activities. We really try to tailor it to what that young Jewish adult is interested in so that it really pairs up with them wanting to explore more about their Jewish identity and, of course, Israel. So speaking of Israel, I don't know, you know, we spoke a little bit. Have you met Israelis before in life? A lot of our participants have never met Israelis. So every Birthright Israel trip is lucky enough to have Israelis on it. So what surprised you the most about meeting Israelis?
You know, like you said, we were really fortunate because all of the soldiers that were on our bus were part of the LGBT community. And so it was a really fantastic opportunity to learn more about what their lives are like and, you know, how they live as queer people in Israel and in the military as well. You know, I think I had a lot of preconceived notions about, you know, the people being monolithic. And that was certainly not the case, you know, whether it was a diversity of political opinion, religious observance or otherwise. I was really blown away by the diversity of even just the people on my bus with me. And, you know, I'll say the other sort of fun surprise, I've been back to Israel twice since my Birthright trip. Both times I've gotten to go to Pride in Tel Aviv. And like you said, it's such an incredible experience. And one of the fun surprises there was the parade is not a parade. Yeah. The floats go down the street, but they are accompanied by what feels like the entire state of Israel.
Yes.
Basically, you find a float that is playing music that you really like, and you dance alongside of it. You celebrate with people from around the world and a diversity of backgrounds. And it's just such a warm and energized environment. It's really a lot of fun. I highly encourage it for anyone, LGBT or otherwise, to experience.
No, I think it's when you're in Israel and you realize that it has this thriving LGBTQ culture, and then when you witness the parade and there's just hundreds of thousands of people marching with you from different backgrounds, and that, you know, and our participants, they do get to experience that, it warms your heart because it truly is a place for every Jew, no matter what. So lastly, you know, you went on the trip in 2010, and we always say, and we definitely believe that a Birthright Israel experience, it really never leaves someone. What you go through in those 10 days, I think stays with you forever. So, you know, can you tell our audience just a little bit about the long-term impact the trip has left on your life? I know it's incredible that you were able to bring so many people back to Israel, Jews and non-Jews, just to experience it. But is there anything else?
Well, I mean, above all else, what Birthright gave me was a deeper connection to mm-hmm. Israel, you know, in a way that I didn't expect, and in a way that has continued to sort of pay dividends. You mentioned the last time I went to Israel for Pride, there were 18 of us that I took back to Israel. Most of them were not Jewish, mm-hmm. and many of them said that Israel was not really in their consideration set for places that they would have considered visiting had we not organized this trip together. And, you know, we were there ostensibly for Pride, but we made sure to set aside time to do a day trip to Jerusalem. We did a day trip to Masada and the Dead Sea. I really wanted them to experience the beauty of the country. And I think it really gave them a deeper appreciation of the culture and the people in Israel and what's going on in that part of the world. And that's the sort of experience that I loved giving back to people that Birthright really gave to me.
And it's incredible. I mean, the more people I think that can experience it, it's absolutely amazing. Anyone who's been knows that. So I think that was all the questions we had for today. Thank you everyone for joining us. Josh, do you have anything else that you want to share with our audience and our incredible donors about your experience? Any last words?
I just want to give a really big thank you to the donors, the supporters, the investors, people who give to this program. It has been incredibly meaningful in my life. And I just want to make sure that people get to continue to experience this fantastic opportunity. And, you know, real kudos to the Birthright Israel Foundation for continuing to evolve and think about different ways that they can meet people where they are and provide a trip that is as meaningful for them as it was for me. So just a big thank you to everyone.
We really appreciate that, Josh. If anyone wants to learn more about Birthright Israel Foundation and the work that we do, you can visit birthrightisrael.foundation. Or, you know, you can follow us right here on social media. And we hope to bring you more incredible alumni stories and hearing firsthand experiences like Josh. Josh, obviously, happy Pride. We cannot thank you enough for not only being an incredible alumni and supporter of Birthright Israel Foundation, but just sharing your story. I hope this brightens a lot of people's days.
Thank you. It has certainly brightened mine.
Yay. Okay. Thank you so much, everyone. We will, you know, speak to everyone shortly. Bye.
Take care.